يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون أياما معدودات فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون
إنه قد أقبل إليكم شهر الله بالبركة والرحمة والمغفرة.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين الله صل على محمد وعلى الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد. Brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah, all praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that once more we have the opportunity to make this brief presentation on behalf of the Academy for Learning Islam. This is our 8th presentation, and today we are going to, of course, respond to a question which has come to us again and again. The question is that it has come in the hadith, and we also had said earlier in our 7th presentation, that in the month of Ramadan, the doors to Jahannam are closed. In the month of Ramadan, Shaitan, in fact, is weak. His evil spirits of insinuations and misleading are weak. Then how come that people continue committing sins while fasting and Shaitan still overwhelms them? Before we answer the question, let me share with you one more hadith in the same regard, so it will be easier. This is hadith number 63 in our book Shahrullah fil Kitab wal Sunnah, compiled by Muhammadi Rayshahri. Baba says, kafakum Allahu aduukum min al-jinn wal-ins. Allah is sufficient for you against your enemy from the human being and the jinn. Ana waqad Allahu azza wa jalla bi kulli shaytanin marid sab'ina malaika. For every shaytan who whispers and misleads, right? Who cast his evil spirits, Allah has appointed 70 angels, right, against them. فَلَيْسَ لِمَهُولٍ حَتَّى يَنَقَتِيَ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ. So there is no way that he can succeed in his scheme, in his plot to mislead you. Until Allah, Prophet said, حَتَّى يَنْكَتُ شَهْرَكُمْ. Until that time, that this month is over. Until the month is complete. So you can see that it clearly says that Shaitan cannot mislead us, or he is weakened in this month. So the question comes, how can fasting help us stay away from sins? Number one, and number two, how is it that there are people who are fasting and still commit sins? First of all, let's try to understand, how does the fast help us? When Prophet is telling us that in the month of Ramadan, Shaitan is chained, right? He is in prison. Satan is in prison. So what is this? Let us look at also other hadiths. In light of those hadiths, we'll get an idea. Prophet says in a hadith, beautiful hadith, he says that, Shaitan flows in the veins of a human being, Ibn Adam, the way blood flows in them. So constrain the movement through hunger. The way know, blood flows in our veins, right? Blood veins. Shaitan flows in us. He's so near us, right? He can affect us. But the Prophet says, constrain the movement of shaitan. This flowing of shaitan, that means he can bring about bad thoughts. He can bring about strength in our limbs to commit sins. He can bring strength in our feet that I go towards haram thing. He would open, you know, what my ears wide open to listen to haram things, because he flows, right? The shaitan has the ability to flow the way blood flows. So Prophet says, constrain his movement through what? Through hunger, through jewel, right? Hunger. So you can see that fasting, because we are hungry, isn't it so, would help us. Because the moment we are fasting, then that flow of shaitan is constrained. Even if he were to mislead us and make us do something wrong, it will take time, because his movement is now slowed down, right? Because we are fasting. That is clearly being told that. And if that's not only, listen to another hadith whereby Mawla Amir al-Mu'mineen Salawatullahi wa Salaamu Alayhi, he says, hunger is the best help, ni'am al-awn, the best support, best help in imprisoning the soul and breaking the habits, right? That soul, that nafsul ammara, right, which all the time, you know, takes us towards evil things, the best way to imprison it, Imam Ali says, is through, you know, hunger. This hunger is the best way, right? You imprison the soul as well as also breaking the habits. People sometimes, they say, okay, I know this is wrong, but I have formed the habit. You want to break the habit? Imam Ali says, hunger is the best weapon. So first of all, you can see that when Prophet is telling us the shaitan is in prison, all those things, this means that the movement of shaitan is weakened within our body. Because he has the ability to strengthen our limbs to commit those sins, right? And those movement of shaitan gets weakened through hunger, right? And then hunger helps us to fight even bad habits. Hunger helps us even to imprison our soul, which is misleading. Do you see? So these are all, in fact, helping us. Besides that, don't forget, this is the month in which we are under the grace, divine grace, lutf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a special help. Because we are the guest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being the guest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just now we heard in our last presentation, what we heard, that in this month, the doors of mercy, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open. So these are the good things which we derive from the banquet, from the divine banquet, right? Isn't it so? So because of that, we are under the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happens? Either because of that, the shaitan is hesitant or reluctant or perhaps weakened or dissuaded to mislead us as he would do in other months. Or because there is a special grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which gives us strength to fight back the shaitan. Let me give you perhaps an example, which is not really the best example, but just a similitude, just to strike a similitude to understand this concept. If we go to the airport, we go through so many formalities until that time that we can board our planes, right? Just we have to go. We have to, for example, check in, your passport, and all those things, and of course go through the immigration, custom lines, and all those things we go through. Almost all the countries have this kind of rules, right? But if you are a VIP guest, what happens? Once you are a VIP guest, you can just go, you know, overcome all these formalities. Just you show your VIP pass and you go immediately to departure lounge and then you will board the plane. Isn't it so? That happens. So because we are the guest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan, He is our host. We have that special grace. And this VIP, you know, is the lutf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This VIP pass with us is, which you receive from the banquet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that lutf of Allah, grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is with us, and perhaps because of that, shaitan is weaker. Finally, the question comes, how is it that we also see people who are fasting, not only on the first day, second day, 10th day, in the last 10 days, In the last week of Ramadan, having fasted all these days, we unfortunately find some people still committing sins. What is the reason? Does it mean that this hadith is not applicable to him? Or this hadith, na'udhu billah, are false? No. We thought about it having the same book, Shahrullah fil Kitab wal Sunnah, has a chapter whereby it's trying to answer this question, but very briefly, keeping in time, you know, what we have, limited minutes, is that first of all, you should know one thing, that shaitan is not alone as a factor for us to commit sins. He's not the only force. When we commit sins, our hadith is telling us, our religion is telling us, there are certain factors. Of course, one of the catalysts is shaitan. He makes us, insinuates us, he whispers in us to commit sin. But there's also nafsul lawwam, nafs ammara, right? We know that nafs ammara, that nafs which is there in us, ammara, that means which continues to command us to commit sins, right? Allah says in Surah Yusuf, Surah number 12, ayat number 53, Inna nafsul ammaratum bisui illa ma rahim rabbi. Inna nafsul ammaratum bisui. How evil is nafsul ammam, right? That it can mislead us. Illa except if the mercy of Allah will be there. So in this month of Ramadan, that mercy is there, right, of Allah. Special mercy is there. But besides shaitan, there's also nafs al-ammara, which we should know how to rein. Which some people have not trained themselves to rein their nafs. And that is why they become victims of it. Number three, of course, besides nafs al-ammara, besides shaitan, the third reason which is the cause of our committing sins is our past record, right? That we have been told in the hadith that every time I commit a sin, there is a dark mark which is put on my heart, right? So when I continue sinning, then my heart is darkened, blackened, and also hardened, right? On account of committing sins. And now if I am not work to seek forgiveness, to show remorse and regret, regarding those past sins, if that has not happened to me, then even if I'm fasting, I would be easily become a victim of committing sins. Because my heart has become so much blackened and hardened. Do you see this thing? So this is why sometimes people commit sins. Otherwise, as we said in our sixth presentation earlier, that if we were to fast, imanan wa ihtisaban, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in the reward which He has promised, and total dedication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you'll find that this fast will help us to stay away from sins. Otherwise, we'll continue to become the victims. We, at the end, quote one shair of Urdu, he says, Hasi aati hai mujhe hazrat insaan par, kare badi khud, aur lanat kare shaitan, right? That human being, that he is responsible for his own actions and then tries to blame everything on shaitan. So of course, there are also other factors which are responsible for committing sins, and that is why sometimes people still commit sins. But we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Ya Allah, in this holy month of Ramadan, when we fast, right from day one to all the way to the last day of Ramadan, give us the strength, ability, increase our tawfiqat, that our spirituality continues developing, that will help us stay away from all sorts of muharramat and forbidden things. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa alihi tahirin. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa alihi.
Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaquna ayyaman ma'dudat. فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام